For people who are not familiar with us, Axis Dance Company is a contemporary repertory company, meaning that we commission the contemporary artists of our time, choreographers, composers, and we have a repertory of work at any given time that might include pieces by, you know, 3 to 5 different choreographers.
Folded line.
I think what sets us apart from other contemporary companies is the fact that we're still rather unique in combining dancers with physical disabilities and non-disabled dancers. And what happens when we do that is that we come out with a palette of movement that is unique to us. And it's a vocabulary that changes as dancers come in and out of the company. But we get to do things that other traditional dance companies can't do because we have highly talented non-disabled dancers who can do everything that, you know, a typical standard dancer would do. And then we have really, really talented disabled dancers. Unlike ballet, where everybody can conjure up an image in their head, you know, or jazz dance or hip hop or ballroom, if you talk about people with and without disabilities dancing, I think the mind probably goes kind of blank because you can't even begin to imagine. There are no images. You know, we're not on Dancing with the Stars, and so you think you can dance, you know, in the popular programs right now.
All men are fools, so says my mother.
So I think you do have to see Axis to believe us, but I think we're accessible to a lot of people that contemporary dance isn't, because it's kind of an amorphic thing, you know, and it's not like a story ballet where you go in and, you know, you can follow along the storyline and kind of get it. Contemporary dance makes you think. Well, I was not a dancer and never thought that I would be doing this with my life. And when I got involved with dance, one of the ways that I educated myself was to go see everything I could possibly see. And what started happening was that I would look at somebody's work and I would think, they could do something really great with us. And I started seeing choreographers whose voice, choreographic voice, I thought would complement our movement vocabulary beautifully. And I was so intrigued by the idea of doing that. And also, I wanted to experience different things, you know, and different people's influences. And I wanted us to be doing different kinds of work. The fun thing about being a repertory company that commissions is that, you know, our work is really diverse, and we might have a dance theater piece up against a piece that's more classically structured, up against a piece that's, you know, dark and moody. You know, because we're not a single choreographer company, we get to really branch out in different directions. You know, we don't have a language in the same way that ballet has a language, you know, that's 200 years old at this point. So learning how to talk about our work and to describe our work has not always been easy, because again, I feel like it's, you know, dance is a visual art, and it's never complete until there's an audience there. And I don't think it can be described in words as well as it can be felt in person. At Montalvo, we're going to be joining Joanna Highgood's Zocco Dance Company in a celebration of Remy Charlotte's career, basically, and his work. And the program is called A Perfect Day. And for this particular event, since it's celebrating Remy, we're going to be building from scratch a suite of airmail dances. And this is something that Remy came up with in the 80s. Where he would draw dances, diagram them, and then send them around the world to different people. And everybody comes up with their own versions, you know, different lengths, some have music, some don't. And it's really a fun way for us to create dances. And we had the opportunity in 2003 for our 15th anniversary to use some of Remy's airmail dances and create some pieces for that. So it's kind of nice to be able to revisit them and with a new cast of dancers and see what we come up with this time. One of the fun things about using these diagrams of Remy's in these airmail dances is that they are not made for dancers with disabilities. And so what happens, and you know, it's often what happens for disabled dancers, is that, you know, we need to take this diagram and make it fit for us and for how we move. And the nice thing about Remy's work is that it's very interpretable. And we don't like to talk about adapting, we prefer to say translating movement. So, you know, we'll look at those diagrams, and I've spent a little bit of time looking at the one that I'll be using and thinking about it, because it's a duet with Santre, thinking about how that particular little picture on that little page is going to translate into something for Sancheré and I. And, you know, some of us have been doing this now for 20 years, and others have an amount of experience, and we've gotten rather expert at, you know, being able to take movement and translate it, and to make movement our own. One of the things that Access has always done is that we've taught our work. And that happened because people, when they first saw us perform, would come up and say, where do I learn to do this? We had nowhere to send them. And now our education program has grown to be about 50% of what we do. It's called Dance Access and Dance Access Kids. And we spend a lot of time doing teaching classes, doing teacher trainings, working in corporations, doing school assemblies. So the fun thing about Montalvo is that we're actually going to be there the whole day. So we'll get to teach and perform. So people get an opportunity not only to see the work, but to come and make their own version of it.